An introduction to Islam in Australia. Although people such as Captain James Cook are credited with discovering Australia in the year 1770, there's evidence to suggest that others had been there before him. Among the people who are thought to have been to Australia before Captain James Cook were the Makassar people of Southeast Asia. For further details on how Islam reached there, please watch my other video about Islam in Southeast Asia. There's evidence to suggest that the Muslims had been to Australia before Captain James Cook, and I'll just be giving a few examples. One example you can see from the map here. Notice just how close Indonesia is to Australia and how close the people were. It's very doubtful that the people moved so far across the Indian Ocean and lived very much next to Australia but had absolutely no idea that Australia existed. There are also other maps drawn by Muslims, such as this map of Australia and also this other world map dated 1421 by Chinese Muslim Admiral Zheng He, which also includes Australia. Historically, the Muslims traded with the areas in northern Australia, such as Amham Land, and they traveled by boat. So notice this photo of this boat, for example. It looks very similar to this other painting, which was made by the Aboriginals, or the native Australians who lived there before the arrival of the Europeans. Again, this was no coincidence. This is just one example of a painting. There are many other more detailed paintings, such as this one here. It's thought that the Muslims used to trade with the native Aboriginals at that time, around this mid-17th century, about 100 years before the arrival of the British Captain James Cook. During that time, the Muslims used to trade something called trepang, which is a sea cucumber and is an important ingredient in traditional Chinese medicine. Later, another group of Muslims arrived in the Australian continent, including Muslims from India, Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan, the Indian subcontinent. They traded livestock, such as camels. So notice in this photo, for example, this woman is actually a native Aboriginal, and her photo is here with a camel. During that time, the Muslims from the Indian subcontinent built the first mosque in Australia, the Murray Mosque. Nowadays, there are still a number of Muslims in Australia, including people from all over the world, such as Captain Muna Shindi, who is originally from Egypt, and she is the first Muslim and first female naval captain of Australia. There are others as well, such as John Ilhan, who is an entrepreneur and ran the successful business Crazy John's Mobile Phones. Other examples are Fawad Ahmad, the cricketer, and Nazim Hussain, who's a stand-up comedian and is Muslim. There are a number of Muslims who also teach the religion, such as Sheikh Shadi Al-Sulaiman, who also appears on Huda TV. There are a number of successful people who converted to Islam as well, such as Carmen Morton. She was the first Olympic champion from Australia for Taekwondo, and she converted to Islam. This is a photo of her with her fiancé, Safwan Khalil, who is also a Taekwondo champion. There are others as well, such as Tony Hussein, who converted to Islam. There's a photo of him here with his wife Zofa, and he's often credited with introducing the sport of surfing to the Maldives. Although they are not always famous by name, there are others who have converted to Islam, including native Aboriginals, such as Anthony Mundane, who's a boxer. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video interesting. Please like and share my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.